in about an hour or so. It's just my pre-workout from the plane, which got swapped for fish and rice because Gatwick security stole my ground rice. Life hack that I've been told is if you freeze your ground rice a bit through security, we rope to the tip for you. So we're going through the airport now. We're going to meet up Dean. We're going to train chest and shoulders, and then tomorrow we're training with straight leg winner Addy O'Gara, which is why we're here. The main reason I'm going to visit another country on mine and Mike's global tour. So get to the gym.
Here, fresh and ready. Animal gym barbell.
Big Dean is very kindly collected us from the airport. Throwing half my intro workout in my suitcase as well. That's a good start. Ready to come on?
So the way I like to train, the way I breathe, the way Jordan Peters is that we tend to do a heavy loading set. We're going to aim for 5 to 9 reps, and then we do a back off where we're heading into the more hypertrophy rep range of trying to stay in around 8 to 12 reps. So obviously the heavy loading set, we're focusing primarily on building strength. And obviously then the back off is where we're going to push the hypertrophy step out. For chest, we're looking at 3 exercises, 2 working sets each. Shoulders, 4 exercises, again 2 working sets each. So with that low volume, you're really pushing intensity. So all the sets are to absolute failure. It's imperative that you do that when you're working at that such low volume, that again you're pushing to the point where you're recruiting those high motor threshold units, again, which you're going to need to end up in response. So hopefully training the guys enjoy the training session. I'm looking forward to it. We're back in my old gym.
Where are we going?
When I lived in Dublin, Animal Barbell. So this gym is really, really cool, really hardcore. Brian is the owner. He's done an amazing job developing here over the last few years. So hopefully you guys like it. As you can see, the rock music flaring. It's a really cool gym. An incline machine. So again, we're sort of focused on the devils. But yeah, don't control it. And then we'll do the pec deck, the dual bar pec deck. Remember that series as well. So we'll do that. We might change things up and do it as a cluster set. Similar to probably what you've tried with Mike, to do 6 sets of 4 reps. But during the muscle round, you hold a stretch for 10 seconds and then you go into each subsequent set, so you're never resting. So I think we might throw that in today instead of the 2 load sets. Then shoulders we'll probably start with again. Shoulder press machine, then follow with delts, so we do a side delt machine. Then what I'd like to incorporate the last one with the shoulder side delts is it's like a complex then we do with light dumbbells. So everyone that's doing their side delts tends to work in the lengthen range. Now it really works. What I like to do there is I throw in 2 sets with all you need is like a 3 or 4 kilo dumbbell, and you're literally just working in that top range. So 2 sets of that, say 15 to 20 rep range, you'll feel absolutely burn. Then we'll do a set of 2 working sets of rear delts, probably rear delt flies or rear delt machine. Biceps, I'll just do 4 working sets, a machine exercise, dumbbell exercise. So let's get cracking.
Thank you.
three reps, feeding into not wasting much energy and just getting a feel for it. You know, gauging the RPE as it goes. And I get to a point where I know, like, that weight that we're doing a feel with is, like, say, an RPE of about 7 or 8, then you know, right, maybe another small increase in weight, and that's it, it works.
Strong squeeze. Seven, good. Let's go. Come on, D. Up. Drive. One more. Let's go. Come on. Up. Drive. Six.
The trick that I got from Glenn, video. A lot of people tend to then arch their back out when they're pressing. You want to make sure that that lower back is neutral, so you actually stabilise the pressing. Because you're actually weak. If you're like this and pushing, you're actually losing some strength in the pec. Because your lower back is empty flex.
That's why
it's sitting into the seat and making sure the lower back stays in contact. Easy work, turn. With it. Easy, yes. Herb. Come on, stay with it. Keep them reps perfect. Come on, I'm with you now. Fight it. Yes.
Come on, Mike, let's go.
One,
good. Two, easy. Three, good, let's go. Four, easy, come on. Five, good. Again, let's go. Six, strong. Again. Up, seven, squeeze, come on, let's go. Now we're working, let's go. Come on, eight, good, let's go. Come on, drive, nine, good. One more, let's go. Come on, let's go. Up, squeeze, come on, another one. Let's go, one more with me, let's go. One more with me, let's go. Up, squeeze. Good set. Let's go, Mike, let's go. Easy.
Fight it.
good. Let's go. Come on. Two. Easy. Let's go. Three. Strong. Come on. Let's go. Let's go. Up, drive, squeeze, come on.
End again. Yes. Yes. Superb turn. Stay with it. Yes. Come on. Come on. Yes. One more. One more. I've got some. Come on. Find it. Find it. Drive. Yes. Yes. Come on.
Come on, Mike. Let's go. Easy. Come on.
Still on you. Fine.
Strong. Good. Let's go, Mike, let's go. Squeeze.
Fight it. It's difficult mentally preparing yourself for the set of 12. Alright, I need to add a little bit more weight or stick a while over the 12 to get to 10. Then when you get to 6 to 8, you're thinking, right, you're sort of grinding to get that 10. You still need a bit more load. So, I don't know. Both of them are evil, but...
Both horrible as each other. Another two plates.
I'd say one or two, and then we'll let into this one. So literally, 4 reps, 6 sets, 10 seconds rest. 10 seconds rest in that stretch. If you get to the 6th set, and you can get past 4, keep going until you hit absolute failure.
Right. Going on this one, yeah?
Really aggressive music, I'm just getting very aggressive. I think you just have to have that mindset that you just flip the switch. Because I mean, even when I was doing kickboxing, you just had to be able to be calm and controlled, and then as soon as the fight starts, you just have to be able to control the aggression.
You say
it's
like I need a pre-workout to train, like, for me, the adrenaline, as soon as I get in here and start moving weights around, I'm fucking fired up and excited.
Yeah, yeah, and I mean, that's why it's useful for people to take caffeine breaks, because you get to a point where you sort of need that pause to get you going for training, but you really shouldn't need that rush to get you excited for training. Even when I took that like 9 week break from February to only a couple of weeks ago, every time I was going in the gym, during pre-workout I was taking this like a non-stim pump formula to just help blood flow. And again, once you get going, of course to encourage blood flow from the pre-workout, the pump formula, when you start to see everything inflate, that's more of a mental cue to drive you on as well. So yeah, it's getting to a point where people like double, triple scooping.
It's like the down regulator,
and it's just, again, you load down top of it, like large coffees and everything else throughout the day, you just get to that point where...
That's why I try and swap in the decaf, and just try and bring my...
Yeah, that's and that's, drink, yeah. That's what I drink mainly, is decaf coffee, and then the only caffeine I'll have is pre-workout. Obviously, prepare as the 250 milligrams, so I find that's just enough now to have me zoned in for the session. Next exercise, so it's chest bone. We're seeing six working, five working sets as we go to the muscle round. So that's chest annihilated. So we took every set to the point of failure. So with shoulders, we're going to start off with dumbbell shoulder press. So what I like to do with these is actually do them with a pronated grip with palms facing in. What we're trying to do there is bias the anterior delt. Because again, when your palms are in, you're taking the stabilization away from, you know, teres, subscap, all the stabilizer muscles at the back of your shoulder. So, palms facing in. What we're going to do is we're going to do like an arc. So, bring the shoulders out to parallel and then drive back in. So, what you need to do here is figure out the incline angle that you're going to be training with the bench. So, you don't want to be perfectly upright or you don't want to be at a full incline either. Somewhere like 80 degrees. And again, what I was saying earlier, you want to make sure that your bum presses deep against the bottom of the pad so that, again, you're fully stabilised, so it's just all shoulders. I mean, even just doing it now with no weight, you'll actually feel, you feel a stretch on your anterior delt. So, again, we'll work the same rep range, 5 to 9, 10 to 12.
Shoulder
trap up, where it really should be elevation. What I like to explain is that you're driving from the elbow as if...
I was trying to think if I was pushing that down as I come up.
Or you can imagine, say someone's standing beside you and you're trying to, you know, push them away from you. That's the sort of intent. That's the sort of intent you want, that you're pushing someone away from the side.
That's quite a good cue. You look in the mirror to look at your shoulder that's actually lifting.
Yeah.
If you look at the line of your shoulder, it's just your arms moving, you're not going up and raising.
That's where a lot of people lose the tension on the shoulder elevation at the top.
Come on, mate, let's go. Let's go, let's go.
Yes. Come on, keep the tension. Come on. Feel it, you don't break down. Come on. Come on. Stay in the rear delt. See it. Seen at the start, like I said, we're keeping the volume super low, but the intensity of every set,
and it's failure,
taking it to failure every single time. Even like at the end with the super set of rear delts and full plate raise, there's no letting up.
No, like, and the tension's on the muscle constantly.
Yeah, and keeping that intensity sky high. It was I really enjoyed the session. It's good to be back in the old gym that I train in.
When nostalgic.
Yeah, nostalgic and the music.
The music's good, vibe, there's plenty of space, so it's good. Well worth checking out.
Heavy rock, metal music, it's been a pleasure.
Yeah, good, we'll get another session soon. We have to fly back over.
Yeah.
Cheers, Dean.
Looking forward to.
Thank you. Post mega session Nando's. Got in the block. Chicken, sweet potato, another pita, French fries, salad, chicken. And Mike, what have you got?
Just new lemon and cucumber salad.
Okay, so pretty much just crashed out after Nando's, just on IG Live. We came back from training, I pretty much, Mike was asleep, snoring away. It's Beauty and the Beast. You can decide who's who. And I did some work and then I lay down and passed out for an hour. So something which is on the debate was whether my food would destroy my bag. It didn't, it made it through, so I've got a big stash of food for the next few days in my lunchbox meal prep. So I'm gonna show you the state of this fridge. Close it properly. So, that's a stocked up for a few days. We're gonna chill, I think, tonight, and then we're gonna go in early and train arms with Trinity with Addy. I'm gonna mess him up. It's gonna be big, good. I don't even talk. Dean pretty much date raped us with that pre-workout earlier. Something that wasn't in there. So, word of advice: if any Irish man tries to give you a pre-workout,